In a little bit more than 2 weeks, it's going to be Black Friday, and you either hate it or you love it, but one thing is for sure, businesses are going to generate lots of revenue. So what I want to do in this tutorial is I want to show you what kind of campaign, what kind of automation you can build inside ActiveCampaign to really get the most out of Black Friday. So I want to show you the automation, I want to show you what kind of emails you could send, and also how you can create the sense of urgency inside those emails. So let's just dive right in. So this is the automation we're going to need for Black Friday. And before I'm going to explain it, I quickly mention I will also put a copy of this in the description below so that you can just import it into ActiveCampaign and change to your own needs. So what we're basically doing inside this automation is before Black Friday, we're going to build some excitement. So here we wait until Tuesday and then we're going to send an email that says something like, hey, this Friday, as you know, is Black Friday. I'm going to do a cool promotion just so you know, keep an eye out on your inbox. Then one day before Black Friday, we want to remind people again, like, hey, tomorrow I'm going to do this amazing offer. You really do not want to miss it. Keep an eye out on your inbox. Tomorrow morning at 10, I will send you an email about the offer. And then on Black Friday itself, we want to send 3 emails. We want to send one in the morning, one in the afternoon, and one in the evening. So let's just start at the top of this automation, and then I will explain step by step how it works. So first, what we do is we wait until. So we wait until a series of conditions is met. So we first wait until the current year is, and then the current year, so in this case, that's 2020, and the current month is November, and the current day of the month is 24, and the current time is 10 a.m. So this wait action will wait until it's the 24th of November 2020, 10 a.m. And then after that is going to continue into this if else. And what this if else is basically doing is we're checking if that person did not already purchase the thing that we're promoting. So for example, in this example, I'm promoting a course that's called Funnels That Convert. It doesn't really exist, by the way. So I really want to make sure that I'm not going to send that promotion to people who already bought that. It would not be so nice, I think. So to do that, we have an if else. So we have either a yes path or a no path. So what we want to check is if someone did not purchase Funnels That Convert. So with my card provider, I'm using ThriveCard, and they're automatically adding a tag to ActiveCampaign when someone is purchasing a product. So then this tag will be added. So I want to make sure that the tag does not exist. Then I also want to make sure that someone did not visit the checkout success page for that product. So in my case, that is checkout/success/product. Is Funnels That Convert, because if someone ever visited that page, then I know, hey, they purchased that product. And the reason why I do this with a tag and also with site tracking is because someone might have purchased with a different email address, but then I hope that with the page tracking, I still know who that actually was or that that person already purchased it. And this is an extra thing that I'm doing, you don't have to do this, but I'm also checking if the current pitch custom field is blank. So I created a new custom field, and inside that custom field, I set the name of the current thing I'm pitching or the current promotion so that I know, okay, don't send this person any newsletters or other promotions. So if that's all a match, so if the tag does not exist, they did not visit that page, and the current pitch is blank, then they follow the yes path. If that's not all a match, then we just end the automation. We don't want to do a promotion for that person. Then we want to update the custom field's current pitch to Black Friday sales so that I know, okay, hey, this person is getting pitched at the moment. They're getting this promotion, Black Friday sale, so don't send anything else. So then all my other automations are basically on hold. And then I send an email that basically says like, hey, upcoming promotion, I'm going to do something cool this Friday. Then after this email, we're going to wait until the current year is 2020 and the current month is November and the current day of the month is 26. So that's one day before Black Friday and the current time is 10 a.m. So one day before Black Friday at 10 a.m., this email will be sent that says like, hey, tomorrow is Black Friday. Then after that, what we do is we say, okay, wait until the current year is 2020 and the current month is November and the current day of the month is 27. So that's the day of Black Friday and the current time is 10 a.m. And then we send people like, hey, today is the offer. It's only available until tonight, so make sure to grab it right now. Just be creative there, right? Also try to stand out from all the other emails that people are going to get. And then, yeah, we want to send a couple of other emails during that day, because people might miss the first email, or they are like, okay, I'm going to think about it for a few hours, then they maybe forget about it. We want to remind them. So I would really recommend to send two or three emails. So then the second email is an email in which I say like, hey, your question's answered. So this obviously depends on what kind of product or service you are selling. So with my online course, I will just try to tackle the main objections that people have by answering the most frequently answered questions people have. And then after that, I'm going to wait until the current time is 8 p.m. So it's only 4 hours till midnight. So the promotion is only valid for another 4 hours. And then what I want to do, you don't have to do this, this is something that I like to do, is I want to check if people engaged with these emails. So what I want to do is I want to make sure that they clicked a link inside the first email or clicked a link inside the second email, because I don't want to spam people too much, right? Or actually not at all. So then if they engaged with any of these emails, then boom, I want to send my last chance email. And if not, then I have here a go to another action and then a go to bomb to the current time is midnight, because then it is skipping the last chance email. So the last chance email, this one, for example, and here I'm just telling people like, hey, first name, this is your last chance. The offer for, and then the product name expires in less than 4 hours. Today, you can get the course for only $500. Tomorrow, the price will go back up to $1,000. Get instant access. And if you're not happy for whatever reason, just write me within 30 days and I'll give you a full refund. And then PS, and this PS is really important, because this PS we're using to create a sense of urgency. So we already tell people like, hey, okay, it's expiring in less than 4 hours. But by inserting a timer inside our email, we make it also very visible when the deadline is. Because maybe someone is opening this email even 2 hours after it's sent. So then it's only 2 hours before the deadline. So then this timer will say like 2 hours and 12 minutes and 13 seconds, for example. So yeah, I really like to use these. And for example, what you could also do is when I link to my sales page or my checkout page, for example, I also like to embed a timer over there. So here, this, for example, a checkout page. And then here I would tell people again, like, hey, this is the offer today. It will expire tonight. And then just to make it visible that the deadline is really expiring in just a few hours, I embedded a timer like this. So to do that, I'm using Timer Campaign. I really like Timer Campaign for this kind of stuff. What it allows you to do, it allows you to create authentic deadlines for everyone. Because what you can do with it is you can not only show a timer inside your email here, for example, or on your sales page, but you can also redirect people to a page like this, an offer expired page, as soon as the deadline is over. Because you want to make sure that as soon as it's midnight, when Black Friday is over, that people can really not access that deal anymore. Because if they can then still access that deal, then there was really no deadline at all. And that basically means that you're just tricking people into buying, right? And we really do not want to do that. So yeah, I myself really like Timer Campaign for this. Another alternative is also Deadline Funnel. But personally, I've used Deadline Funnel in the past. I find it a little bit complicated, and Timer Campaign is much more simpler, and also their pricing is a bit more friendly. So I'll also put a link for Timer Campaign in the description below so that you can check it out if you want to. Now then we wait until midnight. So we want to wait until the promotion is over, and then we want to check, did this contact purchase the offer or not? So to do that, we just check, okay, does the tag exist sales purchased funnels that convert, so this tag gets added by Thrivecart, or has visited a URL that contains checkout success product is funnels that convert ever. If yes, then boom, we know that this person bought. And then what you also see here is you see goals. I have two goals over here. I have a goal for when someone purchased the offer, and I have a goal for when someone is not interested. So when someone purchases the offer, then you can see that here I've set also some conditions. So here we have the tag exist, sales, purchase, funnels that convert, or has visited, then the checkout success page. Then what happens is that a person inside this automation, imagine they purchase right away after this email, then boom, they will skip all the other emails and they will jump towards the goal. So then we don't bother them anymore with all the other emails inside this automation because they already purchased the offer. Now, what I did inside this goal is I checked that. So I checked if the tag exists or if they also have visited the checkout success page. But one thing I also wanted to make sure is that they have been sent upcoming promotion. So I want to make sure that they have been sent the first email inside this automation. And I'm basically just doing that to measure the effectiveness of my automation, because if I would not do that and people would enter this automation over here and I did not end the automation for them yet, then they would also jump to that. So then people who already bought it before they even got the promotion will also jump towards the goal. So that's why I'm checking inside this goal if people also got this first email. Now, then the second goal that I have is here for people that are not interested. So this is something I'm still experimenting with, but I have the feeling people really like it. So whenever I'm doing a promotion, I like to include a not interested link. So you can also see that over here. So in the bottom of my promotional email, I tell people, are you not interested in this offer? Just click here and it won't bother you anymore about it. So this link is going to my not interested page. You can see that over here also. So here it says, ok, no problemo, I won't bother you about this anymore. Take me to the blog, and then a photo, funny photo of me. And why we link to a page is because then inside our goal, we can check if someone clicked that specific not interested link. So this link is in the bottom of every of those promotional emails inside this automation. And then as soon as they click that link, like, hey, I'm not interested, then I'm like, okay, boom, they will just jump to the end of this automation and I'm not going to bother them for this promotion anymore because I still want to keep them on my email list. Because if you would not offer such an option, then they would just unsubscribe, right? And then after that, what I do, I just say, okay, does the contact match the following conditions? Current pitch is Black Friday sale. So I just want to check, is it still the same as what I said here at the beginning? If yes, then just set the current pitch to nothing. So basically just emptying it. And then we end this automation. So I'm just checking that over here. So just in case, maybe they entered another promotion and then I do not want to clear this custom field. So yeah, this is how this automation works. I think it could work incredibly well. So what it basically is just doing, we have the Black Friday, we send 3 emails, and before that we send 2 emails to just warm people a little bit up for that. And then to make sure that people are going to get redirected when the deadline is over to a page that says like, hey, the offer is expired. And also so that you can use timers inside your email, on your sales page, and on your checkout page, I would highly recommend to use a tool like Timer Campaign, because that really makes you your deadlines authentic, but also creates a sense of urgency by using those timers inside your emails and on your pages. So again, this automation, you can just import it in the description below and you can just change it to your own needs. And if you have any questions about what I've just said, just leave me a comment below and I'll try to help you as best as I can.